Hi everyone, welcome back to Kloners. This is Dr. Ramakrishna, a scientist and a researcher working on the rooting aids. In the recent days, we are getting a lot of doubts, queries in our chat box related to the plant cuttings propagation. So why don't we thought of making one complete video guide to achieve the high success rate for the plant cutting propagation. So in this video, we are going to share what are the crucial step-by-step process we are going to implement in our farm to achieve the high success rate in cuttings. Okay, let's start. Step 1. Important step. Okay, selection and grading the stems. While selecting the stems, make sure that they have healthy node and pest breed. And each cutting will be 10 to 50 centimeters in length and having the 3 to 4 nodes on it. I hope you understand step 1, that is selection and grading of the stems according to their category they are belongs to, which is softwood, semi-hardwood and hardwood. One more important thing, to make 45 degrees slant cut both top and bottom of the cutting. Why? Because the bottom slant cut will increase as the surface area. The more the surface area, the more will be the rooting hormone absorption. Whereas the top slant cut will drop down the water droplets to avoid the stem rot. Now gently scratch the thick outer skin around the node without damaging it. This helps better rooting hormone absorption and boosts the roots formation. Coming to the choosing the suitable rooting hormone, as mentioned, for the softwood and hardwood cuttings, you can use from 1000 ppm to 5000 ppm. Depending upon the type of plant species and stem thickness. For the hardwood cuttings, we can even go up to 10,000 ppm. Choosing the rooting hormone and its ppm level mostly depends upon the what we want to achieve. Another important step is choosing the right rooting medium. We can use cocopeat or cocopeat with aerolite combination, but cocopeat must be EC-neutralized, means excess sodium and potassium salts have been removed because they can create a osmotic stress, pulling water out of the stem and dry. To prevent this, wash cocopeat 2 or 3 times, let it dry before use. People also often use direct soil or sand while propagating, but it's not a good approach for higher success rate. Coming to the favorable conditions for cuttings propagation, never expose cuttings to direct sunlight. It causes water loss and can dry the stems. Always place the cuttings in indirect sunlight with higher humidity until roots formation. If you have a rooting chamber or a poly house, that's ideal. Or you can create a simple rooting chamber by using a poly bag, placing the cuttings inside and sealing it. It traps the humidity and encourages the root growth. Don't water cuttings directly. Instead, gently whisk them to maintain humidity, not sogginess. So finally, let's keep it simple. Don't overwater. Too much wetness leads to rot. Make sure there's a good airflow. Rooting media should be light, not soggy always. Maintain minimal humidity. Thank you very much for watching my video. If you found this video useful and informative, please like, share, subscribe to our channel, and If you want to try our Kloners, please contact us.